Sure. All right, break it down. Canelo Chavez Jr., it's an exciting fight. It's a big fight. Are you going to be there?
I won't be there. I'll watch it on TV. You know, All Mexican Showdown. We knew this fight was coming for financial reasons.
I'm excited for it. I think it's great.
Yeah, look, it'll be a fun Mexican showdown. Chavez Jr. has done nothing to earn himself this, but he's there nonetheless.
Look, fans love this, Brandon. You can't argue with numbers. Like, fans are into it.
Look, we've seen Chavez Jr. versus a Bonap 154 before, and it was Sergio Martinez hitting him with everything but the kitchen sink for 11 and a half rounds until he finally got caught, you know, with something until Chavez Jr. finally mounted a damn attack. I think you're going to see more of the same. I think you're going to see Canelo plastering Chavez Jr. with punches, landing on him every time he tries. I think you're going to see Chavez Jr. taking those shots because he's going to be gigantic, and he'll never hit the deck, but he'll just get beaten to the point where a corner should stop it.
Who wins and why?
I think Canelo wins because he's a good combo puncher. He's got serious power in his shots. He's much quicker than the slow plodding Junior. The only thing Junior has is that hopefully Canelo gets exhausted beating the shit out of him and gives him an opportunity to hit him with some shit. You know, that's his only opportunity.
So what are you, 90-10 in your opinion? I think it's a 50-50 fight.
It's probably closer than 90-10 just because of Chavez Jr. is going to be 185 pounds in the damn ring. But I don't, you know, other than Canelo absolutely punching himself out, I don't see any way that Chavez Jr. skill-wise beats Canelo.
So, Brian, right now, who do you have as the top five pound-for-pound fighters in the world today?
Oh, man, you know, again, I'd have to have a magazine in front of me because there'll be names that I'll forget. In no particular order, let's go Terrence Crawford, let's go Keith Thurman, let's go Roman Gonzalez, let's go Triple G. Is that four?
Rigondeaux?
Yeah, Lomo or Rigondeaux, probably Lomo.
What about Mikey Garcia?
Well, you said five, brother.
Okay, well, don't you put him in front of some of those guys?
No. He's just behind those guys, though.
36-0, 30 knockouts.
Yeah, there's a lot of good fighters, but there's only five spots.
And you don't put Canelo in your top five?
No.
You don't put Pacquiao?
No.
You don't
maybe somewhere in the top 10.
All right, stay tuned.
That top five, you know, look, it's what have you done for me lately?
Do you put Chocolatito in your top five?
I say Roman Gonzalez. Oh,
okay. What about Klitschko or Deontay Wilder or Joshua?
Nah, not even close. Not even close.
Kell Brook? Nah. Earl Spence?
Kell Brook just lost his last fight.
Adrian Broner? You can still lose Adrian a B-pound for pound.
Adrian Broner to the brink with his sparring partner. No, doesn't make my pound for pound list. Sorry, Ellie.
I know
it's your boy.
I have him on my pound for pound. Stay tuned. Facebook.com and MoneySickBackReporting.